Let's take a look at the dependence of a cell potential on the concentration of the components of the cell. To do this, to calculate the cell potential under non-standard conditions, we're going to have to derive a new equation. It's called the Nernst equation. First of all, remember the thermodynamic relationship, which was the free energy is equal to the standard free energy plus the gas constant times the temperature times the natural log of Q, the reaction quotient. This very important thermodynamic relationship told us that the Gibbs free energy varies with the concentration of the reactants and products. Q is a relationship of the concentration of the reactants of the products to the reactants at any given position along the reaction path. And if you'll remember, we could plot the Gibbs free energy with the reaction path or the reaction coordinate or the progress of the reaction, whatever you want to call it. And we saw that, for example, for a regular exothermic chemical change, we might start up here with the Gibbs free energy here, and as the time passes and the reaction proceeds, we pass through some minimum to the end, where at this point we would have 100% product. At the beginning, we'd have 100% reactant, and the actual minimum free energy was at some point between 100% reactant and 100% product, and we called that position the equilibrium, which was the minimum free energy position for any chemical change. Okay, that's the relationship that is shown here in this particular equation. Well, since we have a relationship between the standard Gibbs free energy and the standard cell potential at standard conditions, which was negative NF times the standard free energy, cell potential, we can also write a relationship between the Gibbs free energy at any position or concentration times N times F times E at that particular point in time. And so we can substitute in the potential under non-standard conditions, the potential under standard conditions into this equation and solve for a new equation, which will be the Nernst equation. So we've got NFE equals, that's negative NFE, negative NFE standard plus RT natural log of Q. Oops, natural log. Doesn't look like a natural log. RT natural log of Q. Okay, we can rearrange this equation by dividing through by NF. We'll divide through by negative NF, negative NF, negative NF, and negative NF. And we end up with the potential at any point in time along the reaction path, that is under non-standard conditions, is equal to the standard potential minus RT, minus RT NF times the natural log of Q. Now, for the Nernst equation, considering typically what is done is you assume you're at 25 degrees Celsius and you combine the constant temperature at 25 degrees, the gas constant R and Faraday's constant all into one constant and express this as the log base 10 instead of the natural log. And that equation rearranges to give you this, the most common form of the Nernst equation. Okay, which is E, the potential at any stated conditions equals the standard cell potential minus 0.0591 divided by N. N is the number of moles of electrons still that are exchanged in the reaction times log base 10 of Q, and a Q, of course, is the reaction quotient, which is the relationship of the concentration of the products divided by the reactants. This is in the same form as K, only the concentration values are wherever you are at any point in time along the reaction path.